In one of my previous videos, I showed you how to make a book cover mockup for free using ChatGPT, and honestly, the results were surprisingly good. Today, we are going to find out if it is also possible to create KDP book interior mockup images with ChatGPT, and we will compare the results with what I made in Canva. But before we jump in, I have been having a bit of trouble reaching more people lately, so if you are enjoying the content, I really appreciate it if you like the video and drop a comment below. It really helps the channel and tells YouTube this is worth sharing with others. Alright, let's get into it. In another recent video, I walk you through how to create this planner interior mockup in Canva step by step for Amazon KDP A+ content. Today, I am using the same planner interior images, but this time I am going to try to recreate a similar mockup using ChatGPT. So first, I will upload the left side and right side interior page images. Then here's the prompt I am going to try. So here's the logic behind it. I am asking for a photorealistic open paperback book, flat on a surface. I tell it exactly what to use for each page. The file names are assigned clearly, one for the left page, one for the right. That way it doesn't guess and places them exactly where I want. Then I describe the size of the book, 8.5 by 11 inches, and say it's about 150 pages thick, just to make it look real. The black cover is mentioned, but I keep it subtle. Focus is on the inside pages. I ask for soft, natural lighting and a clean background so it looks professional. And finally, I mention a slightly angled top-down view to make both pages visible and give it some depth. Alright, let's run it and see what we get. Okay, at first glance, the photorealistic open paperback book look is actually pretty close to what I was aiming for when I wrote the prompt. But if you take a closer look at the interior pages, you'll notice they don't match the original images. The fonts are slightly different and there are even some typos. And this didn't just happen once. Before this video, I tried a few other interior pages from my books and the same thing happened, especially when there was a lot of text. Now you can try to fix some of these manually using the selection tool to highlight and correct spelling errors, but honestly, that's more of a patch than a solution. The real issue is that these mockups are generated by an AI model that visually interprets images, rather than extracting the exact layout or fonts. That's why sometimes it ends up hallucinating text, especially when fonts are stylized or condensed, the text is in all caps, or the letters are closely spaced. So what we need to do is be super clear in our prompt and tell the model to use the original uploaded images exactly as they are, without trying to recreate or retype any of the contents. Here's the prompt I used that finally gave me a super clean result after testing a few versions earlier. And here's the logic behind it. I ask for a flat lay mockup, so it's a top-down view, no angle. I assign the file names, left page and right page, and say to use them exactly as they are, no edits. There's a small gap in the middle to show the spine, about 30 pixels. I keep the background white and distraction free. Then I add a soft drop shadow, slightly down and to the right, light gray, a bit blurred, just enough to make it look lifted, but still realistic. Oops, this one looks pretty bad. The font is totally off, it looks strange, and there are even some text errors. Actually, this prompt worked well for me before. To fix it, I will try this new prompt. Super strict, super clear. I wrote this because I wanted to be 100% clear. Use only the original images, don't guess or help me with fake content, don't touch the fonts, layout or anything else, just position the images as they are. Okay, let's download this file. And yeah, it actually worked. This time it used the real images, exactly as uploaded. No fake text, no AI remixing. But now we lost the shadow effects. It looks super flat, like the book is printed on paper instead of stink on a surface. So next, I'm gonna write a follow-up prompt to bring back that soft natural shadow, but still keep my original images untouched. Let's do that now. Now I don't want to jump straight into fixing it, because I'm not sure if it was missing or just super subtle. So instead of guessing, I use this prompt to double check. I wrote this to ask for confirmation, not a new image. This way I can make sure the AI knows exactly what kind of shadow I was expecting. And I don't risk messing up the image I finally got right. It's a good trick. If you're ever not sure whether a detail was applied, ask the AI to evaluate first before regenerating anything. And look, I appreciate the confidence, but I am looking right at it, and it still feels totally flat. There's no clear offset, no depth. It's like the book is just printed onto a white background. So now I want the AI to keep everything the same, but actually make the shadow visible this time. And since it claimed the shadow was already there, I'm asking for just a bit more blur and offset to make sure it shows up clearly. I'm telling it to only touch the shadow, and I'm dialing up the blur and offset just a bit, so it actually pops off the background without overdoing it. Still subtle, still clean, just finally visible. Let's run this and see if it finally gives that nice, natural shadow we have been trying to get all along. Okay, so I ran that last prompt, told it to increase the blur, increase the offsets, and honestly, still not good. What it's missing is that subtle shadow along the spine, right where the two pages meet. That shadow is what sells the idea that the pages are part of the same physical book. So now I'm gonna be extra specific. Here's the prompt I'm using. I'm telling it, don't touch my images, keep the existing shadow, just add that center spine shadow for realism. Alright, this version actually looks a lot better. Still not 100% perfect, but it's definitely close to the one I made in Canva in one of my earlier videos. Funny thing is, I got it right way faster in my previous attempts. But this just shows you, sometimes using AI like this is basically rolling the dice. Even if you are super specific, you might need a few tries to get what you want. Anyway, now that I have got something I'm almost happy with, I just want to add a little final polish, a light gray background, and a soft drop shadow underneath the whole thing. But I don't want it to touch the actual book image again. Just place it on that kind of background like we do in Canva. Here's the prompt I'm using for that. That should give it that final professional look, clean, subtle and super usable for mockups, product listings or whatever you are building. Okay, this version looks better now. The background and shadow helped and it's actually close to the one I made in Canva in my earlier videos. Even though ChatGPT is really successful at generating book cover mockups, you can also make interior page mockups like we just did. But honestly, if I need something like this for Amazon KDP A+ content, I would still prefer doing it in Canva. It's just more straightforward and I can control the sizing without surprises. Like I said, this AI model still interprets images more than it reads them. Hopefully, that gets better in the future. If you want to see how I make interior page mockups in Canva, be sure to check out the video link in the description. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up and drop a quick comment. Even something simple like helpful or keep going really helps support the channel. Thanks so much for watching and I will see you in the next one.